Charlie figures life's a game. You might lose, you might win, it don't make no difference. You still try to do the right thing. He leaves the yard, puts the keys in mom's car, about to head out in the world, try to figure out where all the duns are. Sees our old dear struggling with her shopping bags, dropping cans, he's not off popping tags. He's stopping and he's offering hands. Finds a crew on a park later, building Ziggy after Ziggy. Knows he won't have one job, even trying to quit the Ziggy. Spies a girl he likes, wordy type, heard she might like him too. Granny said he's handsome, girls got him feeling hyper. Truer brother Danny boy, he's a proper liability. Likes to run his chops, yo, he thinks that he's the illest. We know the type, silly kid plus Billy Whiz. Charlie figures that's probably all the deal he really is. Danny's this typical kid who got bored of the swings, became a lord of the tins. That's where the story begins.
So he spots Teresa clutching on the regular spot, bro. It's springtime, this girl is buff, I'd call it some puppy love, yeah. Sick to the stomach, he approaches her cautiously, looking up from his shoes, trying not to be forceful, seen. He catches her eye, she seems sadder than usual. Behind her pupils, it seemed like she's been through it all. He asked her what the problem is and how he could help, and she replied that she was grown and she could deal by herself. Taking her snapping as rejection, he begins to walk away. Feeling awkward, she calls and says, sorry, I'm off form today. My brother Danny on some bollocks, proper pissed me off. And things are tough at home, our things are going lost. Charlie answered that he knew her brother, he weren't that bad. Just the sort of lad that ended up on the wrong track. Wrong mans he's clutching with, wrong hands to guide the boy. They spied Danny proper pissed on the side of boy.
You're right there, Danny, Charlie says. Figures best to be safe, cause he's kinda short on charming ways. Teresa likes mates of his too, they make a big crew. Needs a way to stand out, best way to move me. Brethren's with the brother charming, bro, truth be told. The girl's eyes are warm and his world feels cold. Danny boy seems unimpressed, just asking after tats and that. Can you get us beers done? Charlie has to think at that. Suppose I go, leave the keys at home. I could mission back down. Danny grins, sees a song. Charlie sees, could stretch to some super bar. Pretty soon they're arguing about footy, catching out whose shoes are hot. Teresa sees the boys talking, not sure how to feel. He looks a nice lad though, seems he's on the real. A few weeks pass, a month, a year. Charlie seeing Teresa, now him and Danny's on the beers.
At the start, it was like he only cotched around to impress Danny's sister, but since then he often found that he was up for the sesh as much as Danny was. Banging back beans, didn't see what the damage was. His newfound was losing his marbles, bro. Danny flipping out randomly, but still always smiling. So Charlie thought it was a phase. This man is bruv still, and now they call each other duns, cause the love is real. Both pissed. I hope you've been listening thus far. Danny asked his mate if he could borrow his mum's car. At first he was against it, but he fancied the buzz, bruv. Buzzing down the road at 80, skidded and fucked up. At the T junction, he smashed into a white Merc. An old deer in the passenger, and Danny's got a slight smirk. Out jumps the driver, Charlie terrified and mad tense. He turns round, Danny done one over the fucking fence.
Charlie's out the car and he sees the other driver.
Shit, the dude's a lunatic, he'll be lucky to survive the
beating he's about to get. The guy looks 35,
he's about 6'7" and he's nearly as wide.
He's grabbing Charlie by the throat, squeezing, breathing's getting hard now.
The lunatic, he's grinning, saying, where's your fucking spars now?
Vision's blurring, slurring words out, where the fuck is Danny?
He's thinking, oh, that's that. Then he clocks the hard nuts granny.
Sink it off of him, the lad's alright, I know him from round eyes.
He helps me out all the time, it's the other lad that crashed the cars.
Thank fuck for that. Thank fucking fuck for that.
Next day, Charlie's glad he's not dead, but his mum won't even look at him.
She knows coppers would have got him and they would have threw the book at
Danny
him.
Danny turns up later, tries to run the thing like it's funny.
Like, here, whatever it do to you, don't look too bad, Donny.
He just had a word with me, said watch out who you booze with.
Be careful who your crew is, don't choose to move with losers.
You'll get some cuts and bruises if they do one when it's deep.
He slams the door in Danny's face, thinks I'm going back to sleep.
Charlie, what the fuck have you done to the car, you fucking wanker? You've been with my brother again. Fucking dick.